time. My name is Taka. I started competing in 2007. I used a blend of Arabica and Robusta. My roaster couldn't share any details of my coffees. It was normal back then. Over the years, Arabica took over, showcasing amazing flavors. Now, in the recent years, Robusta has begun to catch up, thanks to modern fermentation techniques. So like I did, I'm going to serve you the blend of Arabica and Robusta. But this time, it's my choice to give you the best espresso possible. Taking the best of Robusta, the body, and the best of Arabica, the flavors. So let's start with espresso. Please have a look at my card on your left. My Arabica is Geisha variety from Finca Hartmann, Panama. Natural anaerobic fermentation. The producer, Latibo Hartmann, has green and bronze tip geishas, giving citrus and tropical fruits note to the coffee. Today as orange and pineapple. He applied 130 hours anaerobic fermentation and then dried in cherries, giving grapefruit note to the coffee. Today as red grape and white wine aftertaste. My Robusta is TR4 variety from Eaton Cooperative in Vietnam. Also a natural anaerobic fermentation. This variety at this farm grows at 1,000 meters above sea level, which is higher than any other farms in Vietnam. That's why the cherries ripe slower, developing great sugar contents, giving more sweetness, more body to the cup. Then the coffee was processed as anaerobic fermentation for 5 days, and then dried in cherries, removing the vegetal and tobacco flavors of Robusta. I'm dosing 90 grams of geisha and 1 gram of Robusta, extracting 40 grams out in 22 seconds. Once I serve you espresso, please evaluate the crema and wait for my instruction. Don't drink yet. Please, evaluate the crema and wait for my instruction. Please evaluate the crema. Sorry. Please wait for my instruction. Okay, your taste experience. Please write down. Medium sparkling stoic acidity. Medium sweetness. Low bitterness. First sip, pineapple, orange. Second sip, red grape, pink grapefruits. Medium body, smooth mouthfeel. and long-lasting aftertaste of ホワイトワイン like Riesling. Please stir three times and go ahead. Please put the used spoon in the black glass. Enjoy. So let's move on to a milk drink. I'm dosing 17 grams of geisha, 3 grams of lobster, extracting 40 grams out in 21 seconds. By having more lobster, it highlights the sweet flavors in the cup. Your taste experience. Please write down. Dark chocolate. Dark cherry.バニラ and please enjoy buttery mouthfeel. My lobster TR4 was recognized as a variety back in 2006. Almost like me, starting to compete as a barista. TR4 normally has big body, herbal note, and decent bitterness. Thanks to the anaerobic fermentation,This bitterness is rounded. And now, matches very well with my Arabica. My approach to blend is to roast Arabica and Robusta separately. For Arabica, I chose to emphasize the flavor by roasting short.For Robusta, I chose to emphasize the body by having longer roast. Please enjoy. Please enjoy. Just a moment, please.I manage different solubility of each roast by having separate grinders. Fine setting for Arabica. coarser setting for lobster. Thank you for waiting. Please enjoy. Please enjoy.Okay, for my signature drink, I was inspired by Espresso Martini, a classic, amazing drink. I'm dosing 15 grams of geisha, 5 grams of lobster, extracting 36 grams out in 16 seconds. By having even more lobster, it boosts the flavors. Please have a look at my card. My first ingredient is rose petal.The freshening, just matching the floral note of my coffee. Cardamom seed, giving a spicy kick to my coffee. Hops, highlighting a stoic note of my coffee. This is my first ingredient, herb distillation. I add all them for one day. I add 40 grams of this distillation, so your first sip will be citric and botanical.Today as limoncello and juniper berry. My second ingredient is Japanese sugar. It's called kokutou. It's made by sugarcane juice that is cooked for a very long time. The intensity of this sugar matches well with the sweetness of my espresso. I add kokutou syrup. I made a syrup with kokutou sugar and water at a 1-to-1 ratio.I add 15 grams of this kokutou syrup, so your aftertaste becomes long-lasting with a note of white chocolate today. My last ingredient is coffee packs. Coffee packs. I collected coffee packs from my practices. Added water and koji, which is Japanese fungus. Then fermented in this sealed container.For 2 weeks in the anaerobic condition, just like my coffee. It becomes paste and offers rich umami. The red fruit note of my coffee, today as red grape, turns into peach. I add 0.5 grams of this into the drink. And here are my 4 shots of espressos.I add stainless ice cubes and shake together to give some texture. Okay, your espresso martini is served cold. And please enjoy 2 sips. Your taste experience, please write down.First sip, limoncello, juniper berry. Second sip, peach. Silky mouthfeel with aftertaste of white chocolate. Thank you for waiting. It's a great pleasure for me.To have served a blend of Arabica and Robusta and Espresso Martini, like I did at my very first competition 15 years ago. And I'm also looking forward to the next 15 years to come as barista. Please enjoy my Espresso Martini. Thank you so much. Time.